think this is a really interesting time with regard to meningococcal disease in the UK, because we have such an effective meningococcal C vaccine, and now we have a meningococcal B vaccine which is licensed in Europe.
There are around 1,800 cases of MenB per year. This is a really devastating disease, and we get to know some of these families really well, particularly the ones with more severe after effects.
My daughter Charlotte had meningococcal septicemia in December 2010. It was like a real emergency fight, you know, for Charlotte's life. She was in hospital for 6 weeks. Her limbs had died off and they needed to be removed, and she was probably, I'd say, better after having the operation. And that was the start of her recovery.
Apart from the fact that, unfortunately, some children die, some children are also left with amputations, skin damage, hearing loss, and sort of behavioural and cognitive after effects that affect them at school and with their development later on in life.
It is the last remaining serious cause of invasive disease in children. We know that most cases of invasive meningococcal disease are due to serogroup B. The problem is, of course, that there, within serogroup B, there are a number of different strains, and this is a vaccine that covers a subset of those strains, not all of them. So we are in a different position to when we think about a meningococcal C vaccine, which is essentially covering all the different types of serogroup C. Another really important aspect will be how it's received by the general public. We know that this is a vaccine which is quite reactogenic. The fever rates are significantly higher than other vaccines given in infancy, but it's against a disease which in all polls in parents of young children is number one in terms of prevention. So that's an interesting balance there. Will parents, will those who have to deliver the vaccine, accept a vaccine which is more reactogenic because it will potentially prevent a significant proportion of a disease which is really important?
On a recent visit to the hospital, I did speak to the team and said, please, when this vaccine is available, can my family be, you know, at the front of the queue, because this is such a worry for us.
We at Meningitis Research Foundation are really delighted that the JCVI have recommended this MenB vaccine for introduction to the routine schedule. We know that this will help prevent many more cases of this devastating disease, and we know from the families that we're in touch with who have already been affected that they can now give protection to their other children and know that families in the future won't have to go through the same thing that they have.
It's fantastic that the vaccine's there. Obviously it brings out lots of different emotions. It's bittersweet as well, because, you know, I think what could have been for Charlotte if she had not have suffered this illness.